Pat Love from Love Healing Hearts, back again to talk about prophetic dreams and visions, okay? All right. Now, this is an old dream from Believe, one of my regular viewers. And in this dream, I'm going to read and, you know, comment and do my little thing like I always do. Okay, here we go. Sister Love, in December of last year, I was out of my area, New York, visiting a relative in another state down south. I had a very disturbing dream. I don't recall the whole thing, but what I do remember was shocking. In the dream, I was back home in the New York area. A missile came from the east, which would be the Atlantic Ocean region. When it hit the ground, it looked like the pictures we see of Hiroshima. After the rocket hit the ground, everything turned completely bright, bright, bright light, piercing white, and there was complete, utter silence. I was in a building or a house and just waiting for the fumes or whatever to overtake me. But I have to say, I wasn't frightened. I was at perfect peace, knowing that this was the end on this earth. I pray this does not happen with nuclear bombs, but too many are having the same type of dreams and visions. If anyone is reading or hearing this and does not know the Lord Jesus Christ, please, please call out to him. Repent and acknowledge Jesus. He is our only hope. He wants us all to be saved. And Pat Love's two cents. It is not his will that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Amen? So listen, when these people are having these dreams, they're not trying to give you nightmares. They're not trying to threaten you or blackmail you into the kingdom. No. It is out of love. You tell your child out of love not to play around with the plug on the electrical socket. You tell your child out of love not to play with glass or pick up broken glass so they don't get hurt. Well, God tells us out of love to accept his son who out of love gave his life on the cross for the remission of our sins. He died in our place. Listen, when the Bible says that we are shapen in sin and born in sin and shapen in iniquity, this is what he means. Okay, I'm going to break it down now. If you see a child at the cookie jar and you peep at him, don't let him know you're looking. You know that child. Nobody teaches him this. He knows how to reach his hands there and sneak him out a little cookie or two. He knows how to do that. Nobody taught him how to steal. Here's another one. When you call him on it and say, did you just take a cookie from the cookie jar? No. Did you teach him how to tell that lie? No. It's in our nature. That's what the Bible means when it says we're born in sin and shaping in iniquity. Do you hear me? It takes a new nature to change us. It takes a new nature to make us sensitive to things that are right and wrong. The new nature makes us care enough to try at least to do things the right way. Do you hear what I'm saying? So that is why we need to be born again, because being born of the Spirit means that we have accepted our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And we have relinquished to him our old nature that makes it easy and instinctive for us to lie, to steal, to cheat, to connive, to do whatever. and accept His Holy Spirit that makes us want to tell the truth, makes us want to take responsibility for our actions, and it makes us want to change our actions for the good, and gives us the ability to do so. So, all that to say, please give your heart to the Lord. I'm not talking about escaping from hell's fire and brimstone. Whether that's real or whether it's not, there's a song that says, if heaven never was promised to me, neither God's promise to live eternally, it's been worth just having the Lord in my life. Living in a world of darkness, He gave me the light. If there were never any streets of gold, neither God's promise that we would never grow old, it's been worth just having the Lord in my life. Living in a world of darkness, He showed me the light. Now, I say that to say, whether you believe in heaven or hell is neither here nor there. If it's there, it's there. If it's not, it's not. So I'm not arguing that with you. I'm not even touching that with a 10-foot pole. I know what I believe. I believe what the Word says. The Word says there is a heaven and a hell. Anyway, moving right along. I'm not arguing that. What I'm saying to you is, would you rather go through life having to take all the bumps and the scars and the crap that life throws at you with no buffering, with no painkillers, with no healing salve, with no comfort, with no hope? Or would you rather have the God of the healing salve, the God of peace, the God that encourages, the God that protects you and shields you and works things out that you have no power to work? Knowing that God is on my side makes it so worth it. If there's nothing at the end of this line but nothingness, it's been worth it to me to have the Lord on my side. Living in a world of darkness, God came and showed me the light. And I don't have to live a life of self-destruction. I don't have to be full of self-hatred anymore. I don't have to be full of insecurities, trying to navigate and juggle through emotional hurt and bondage and fear and sadness and emptiness. I don't have to live that way, because God came and put inside of me something I couldn't find in this world. And that makes my life worth living. That took me from being the walking dead to being alive and loving my life, loving myself, having hope, having constant reassurance, seeing His hand move in my life. It's been worth having the Lord in my life. Living in a world of darkness, He brought me His light. He showed me His love. He showered me with His supernatural love from heaven. No man, no pill, no psychologist, no high, no sex can do that for me. That is something only God can do. And He does it to me through His Son, Jesus Christ. That's why you need to give your heart to the Lord. Because all those things you've been scratching and digging for all your life can only be found in our loving God, our Father in heaven. God bless you.